I must point out, Jose, that HSBC made an outstanding call in December looking for double-digit equity growth. Morgan Stanley this morning with a global sell on equities. Does HSBC share the gloom?
We share, well, not as dramatically, but we actually share that. But we did it 2 months ago. We cut our Chinese positions, our overweights in China about 2 months ago, cut our U.S. positions about a month ago. And what we're looking for is the adjustment to the Fed reality.
Off the HSBC optimism of 6 months ago, mm-hmm. is it a single-digit world? Is it a flat world? Or could there actually be this as good as it gets in equities?
Well, I think we need to retrench on two fronts. Number one is the trade agreement that everybody thought is done. It's not done. It still needs to have work done. That's number one. Number two is the Fed reality. They're not going to, we don't feel they're going to cut three times in the next 2-3 months. We feel they cut twice in the next 6 months. And that adjustment has to filter through to markets. After that, we think with an improved trade picture, we think the economy improves. We think our earnings picture improves, and therefore we still like U.S. equities. So we're keeping our powder dry to go jump back in.
Jose, what happened with the Fed expectations? I mean, did the market, you know, Mr. Clarida was pretty clear 6 weeks ago, and then the market seemed to have just gotten ahead of themselves.
Yeah, I think that's exactly right. The market did get ahead of itself, and I think the Fed has been pretty clear in terms of what they're going to do. They'd like to try to help the economy, but if you look at the jobs report we got the other day, unemployment rate ticked up, but 224 on jobs, and we're in pretty good shape with wage gains. The consumer looks relatively healthy. It's hard to envision a scenario where the economy is that weak and the Fed needs to move that quickly in such a short period of time. That's not our view.